Everyone, how are you guys? Welcome to today's video. As you can see, it's a budget with me video and it's for October, paycheck number one, which means for me, it's from the beginning of October, from the 1st to the 15th. Now you can obviously adjust this to what your pay schedule is. Now before we get started, this is a budget for a single 28-year-old girl living in Philadelphia. And huge twist, if you haven't been following my videos, I am currently unemployed. And that is pretty much the update as of right now on myself. I am still unemployed. I've been on a few interviews, so I'm going through that job hunt process, but I'm being a little bit more picky, I feel like, at my age, of, you know, where I wanna work. And I think I'm gonna do a whole video on that because a lot of you guys are curious as to what I've been up to and all of that. And yeah, so let's just jump into this video here. If you have yet to subscribe and you enjoy my videos, please hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you know exactly when I post my videos. And then you can follow me on Instagram as well, at Jerlyn Fawn, and there you can check out my personal life and what I'm doing behind the scenes. I do a lot of behind the scenes footage and videos on my Instagram as well. So, all right, let's just jump right into it. So October paycheck number one. First off, I can't believe it's October already, which is crazy to me, but yeah, I'm just gonna jump right into it. If you've been watching my budget videos for some time now, you guys know that I don't share my paycheck, my salary, anything like that, just for privacy reasons. So I'm going to leave that blank, but if you are personally doing this budget layout yourself, this is where you put your paycheck or your salary, anything like that. So that would go there. Miscellaneous for me, I have this because, you know, I do YouTube on the side, I have my Poshmark sales, my website sales. So for the beginning half of October, I really only have $78 in sales on my Poshmark, which is where I, you know, post my like purses and clothes and brand new makeup. So if you are curious, my Poshmark is always listed in the description box. So I have a little bit coming in there along with whatever I get for my check. All right, obviously for yourself, total it up right here. And as you can see, I went with a more simplistic layout today. I didn't do the highlighters and I didn't do any colors. I just decided to do plain black and white and just did the little squares around the headers. Okay, so moving down, sorry, that was a random tangent, but moving down to fixed expenses, my rent is something else I do not share currently. That might change in the future, but I did get a question on, you know, does she just not pay rent? Why did she leave it blank? Since the beginning of my budget videos, I never shared what I pay for rent, so it just is what it is. Thank you for respecting my privacy, and for those who don't, again, there's other videos that are out there that you can watch. You know, I don't think you need to know every single aspect of my life, but that's just what I think personally. All right, so rent would go right here, whatever you pay. And then for water, my water and electric bill actually didn't come in the mail yet, which is really odd. So it's pretty consistent every single month. So I'm going to write in what it was last month, which was $33.76 for water, and then electric was $67.10. My rent comes out on the first. Water and electric should be coming out on the 4th of each month. Okay, Apple, which is my storage, it's only 99 cents, but that comes out on the 8th. And then pets, I do have a cat that lives with my mother. I don't have my cat here at the apartment, but I do still pay for its food, litter, all of that. So that is $42 for my cat. And this kind of comes out randomly, but I'm just gonna put the 14th. All right, so now we're going into automatic savings and debt snowball. For yourself, if you are using this as a guideline, you know, do what you can, put away what you can for automatic savings. Some people put away $100 a paycheck, $200, $300, whatever you can finagle in your budget. You know, some people make a lot of money and some people don't. That's plain and simple, let's be honest. So I used to automatically save $250 if you've watched my previous budget with me videos, but since I've been unemployed, I really, really had to cut back. I think last month was like 100, and yeah, the month before that was 50. And I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I don't have too much to work with to put away for savings. So for October, I'm going to put nothing in savings. just because of my circumstances. You guys know, again, I'm gonna do a more in-depth video on how I'm feeling, because it's been a little bit over a month since I've been unemployed, so I'm sure you guys are curious about how I'm feeling, the job hunt, all of that. So I am gonna make a video, and that is coming up probably within the next week or two. Okay, so debt snowball is another, you know, little category for me that I would love to add money towards, but unfortunately with my unemployment, I am not putting any additional money towards debt. I am paying pretty much my minimum right now on all the debt that I do have currently, and that's just my current situation, so it is what it is. All right, down here is denominations. We're going to come back to this section after we fill out all of this. Okay. So variable expenses for groceries, I'm going to keep it at $100. It was actually pretty easy to just have $100 for myself for 2 weeks. It wasn't hard at all, which is breaks down to $50 a week. So if any of you guys were curious as to if it's been hard to have $50 a week for groceries, no. I'm a single girl and it works. I feel like this is more than enough now, which, you know, it really opens my eyes, because before when I started these videos, I was putting aside so much money for, you know, just groceries. So $100 has been working out. I could probably cut that down even more, but I'm not going to just yet. All right, so gas is typically $50. I have been not driving too much and not going anywhere, so I have been saving in gas, but I always put $50 just in case, you never know. All right, eating out, entertainment, and personal. This has been zeroed for the past, what, 2 weeks, I think? 2 to 3, no, probably 2 to 4 weeks. Yeah, so eating out gets nothing. Entertainment, I'm not giving myself any money for entertainment or for personal. I'm not in the position to just yet. So yeah, Uber, Lyft, and parking. So I budgeted $40 last video, and honestly, I could probably cut that down to even just 30, because again, I'm not really going anywhere. Everything that I'm doing is pretty much at home. You know, I'm taking care of myself, you know. Anywhere that I am going, it's probably for an opportunity or anything like that. A lot of my friends are very understanding with the fact that I am unemployed, so they try to come to me instead, which is great. So, all right, so the total here for this section, very sad. Oh, it looks so pathetic, but it is $180 for my variable expenses. Now, which ones of these are cash envelopes? Some people are still confused with cash envelopes. I don't have cash envelopes for every single thing in here, but most of them I do. So groceries is a cash envelope. So I always pull out money, and this is what I carry to the grocery store, so I know this is what I have to spend. Gas is on my credit card. So I like to, you know, use my credit card to, you know, one, build credit. But yeah, this is just easier to swipe my credit card at the gas pump, honestly. So this is not a cash envelope. Eating out is a cash envelope. Entertainment is as well, and personal, but as you guys see, they're all zero, so I haven't been using these envelopes, but I still have them. And I'm leaving these categories in here because, you know, once I figure out my job situation, I'm going to go back into these. So I really want you guys to have a visual on what envelopes I am using and which ones I'm not. Okay, Uber, Lyft, and parking is very similar to gas. All three of these are linked to my credit card, so I don't need a cash envelope. So our grand total of cash envelopes is just $100 that we need to take out of the bank. Pretty straightforward. I hope that makes sense. If you have any questions, leave them down below. Okay, so sinking funds. You guys know, I said this in my previous video, I love to add to my sinking funds. I love to see these envelopes grow. And if you're curious, every single sinking fund I have is a cash envelope. So I have one for all of these categories. And as of late, you guys know, I haven't been adding much money to them because I can't. I'm unemployed. You should make this into a game. How many times does she state that she's unemployed, right? Take a shot. You're gonna be drunk by the end of this video. All right, so travel, I'm going to add nothing into my travel fund because I'm not going anywhere anytime soon, and that's okay. I feel like some people feel like ashamed that they don't get to travel as much, or, you know, they're bummed out because they don't have the money to go to all these beautiful places that other people are going to. But it's like, guys, work on yourself, get yourself to a place where you can do that. And this is kind of an example to show you guys, like, I love to travel and I would love to post pictures when, you know, if I'm in like Fiji or if I'm in like South America, I would love that. I have tons of friends who do that. But at the same time, like, I know my situation right now and I know I just can't be traveling. So don't feel bad if you don't make a lot of money right now or if you don't have a lot of money. It's okay. You're not alone. Okay, so emergency is definitely a category I still like to add to, even if it's just a little bit. So emergency fund, I'm going to add $20. And then medical is another one that I like to constantly add little by little, so I'm going to do $20 there. Car maintenance, I decided to not add to car maintenance this particular paycheck because I wanted to add more into the emergency and medical. Like, originally I was thinking about just doing, like, you know, $10 in medical and $10 in car maintenance, but I figured, you know what, this round I'm going to do 20 in medical and nothing in car maintenance. Birthdays are on hold, Christmas is on hold, new car is on hold for sure. Apartment, I don't really need anything else for my apartment. I think the last thing I purchased for my apartment was that plant. If you watched my vlog from that day, I bought a plant for my apartment because I really needed to fill that plant holder, let's be honest. Okay, and then projects is something else that I typically like to add to, but I am not this round. I'm just not in that position just yet. So this is very slim and sad. I mean, this is a budget of an unemployed single person. So it is what it is. I have, you know, other bills to pay. I have other expenses elsewhere, as you guys can see. And, you know, saving right now is just, I'm not in the position for that. So our total cash envelopes from our sinking fund section. Oh, actually, I'm sorry. Let's total this out. This is $40. And then the total for cash envelopes, which is 40 plus 100. So we need to take out $140 at the bank. All right, so when we go to the bank, we need to ask them for certain bills so we can, you know, split them into their cash envelopes. So let's start at the top. For our groceries, we need $100 for groceries of the 140, right? So I'm gonna do 150, two 20s, and a 10. I like to have small bills on hand just in case I go to the local corner store that only accepts small bills and only accepts cash. Okay, and then the next thing we have is just these two right here. We need a 20 for emergency fund and then another 20 for our medical fund. So when we go to the bank, it's pretty straightforward. We're gonna ask for 150. We're gonna ask for four 20s and one 10. So I'm going to head to the bank and I will be right back. All right, everyone, we are back from the bank and we have our cash right here. Before we get into stuffing our cash envelopes, as you can see, I did wanna offer you guys a giveaway. A lot of you guys have been asking me, where do I get my cash envelopes? Do I buy them? Do I make them? I actually make these myself. I do not wanna start selling them because they're not the best quality. I mean, they work for me and I made them for my personal use because they're not perfect and I don't mind that they're not perfect, but a lot of you guys have requested for me to do a giveaway. So I'm going to do a giveaway for someone who wants to win a set of cash envelopes. I haven't decided how many I'm going to make for the winner yet, but if you do want to win a set of cash envelopes from me with this more kind of neutral design with this gold foiling, please thumbs up this video and leave a comment down below as to why you want to win a set of cash envelopes from me. Yeah, I don't plan on selling these ever, but I figured I would do a giveaway for those who are interested in budgeting and starting to budget. So yeah, you will get a set of cash envelopes that are going to be something like along the lines of these and then these patterns as well. I haven't decided yet, but we will see. So please be subscribed to this channel. Also, thumbs up this video, leave that comment, and for a bonus entry, you can follow me on Instagram at Jerlyn Fawn. Okay, so let's just jump right in and get started. I'm going to start off with my orange envelopes, which are my variable expenses. As you guys can see here, these three envelopes, cash envelopes, are zeroed. So we're going to take these three and put them to the side because we're not using them currently. The one that we will be stuffing is my groceries, which is $100. So we'll take this 50. Whoopsies, we'll take two 20s, move that up, and we'll take a 10. So that's $100 for groceries for 2 weeks. So that is all set and done. Once I get more into the swing of things with a new job and everything, I will be doing update videos for you guys, like weekly update videos. But for now, since I only have one envelope that I'm spending from, there's really no need to update you guys with this. Let's be honest. That video would be like a 30-second video. Okay. So now we can get into our sinking funds. So you guys can see here, a lot of these are zeroed out, and that is just my life right now, and that's okay. So yeah, travel, we're not putting anything in travel, so we'll set that aside. Emergency, we will be doing $20 in here. So let's take out this, see what we have. So we're gonna add the 20 in here, and let's count it. So we have 100, 150, 170, 190, 191, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 197 total for our emergency envelope. So pretty good, we're racking that back up. And then the last envelope that we will be stuffing this time is our medical envelope. This is very, very slim because I had to spend the whole thing at once a couple weeks ago, but now we have 20, 40, 60, 61, 62, 63, $64 in our medical envelope. So we're trying to build this one back up. The rest of these envelopes are not seeing any love, unfortunately, but that's okay, you guys. It's okay. So these will have zero going into them this paycheck, but we will get there. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed the stuffing of the cash envelopes, my sinking funds, and my grocery envelope. Again, if you are interested in winning a set of cash envelopes from me, then leave a comment, be subscribed, follow me on Instagram, and thumbs up this video. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye!